Good evening, and I'm back. And for this evening, I want to continue working on the item stacking and item splitting. And maybe I will be able to finish that today, otherwise I need to continue with it tomorrow. And then maybe next week we will begin with actually creating content, as in designing characters and writing dialogue and stuff like that. But for now, I want just to finish the few mechanics I have still in here that are not special cases in the game itself, but global systems I need to finish off. And one of these systems is the item system and inventory system. And I just looked through my project and saw that I have a lot of pickups flying around here. And every time I drop a pickup, it will also put in the normal hierarchy, and I don't want that to be that way, so I was thinking about maybe adding a empty object here and just call that something like pickup holder, and then put every pickup I have under this. And I also need a variable for it in the game manager, and then connect it to this pickup holder so that I can parent all the pickups to it in code when I'm adding them. That way I can have more control over all the pickups I have in here. And I have pickups in here as well. And all of them are now sorted in here. And I could even make a list and pool them, but I think it would be a bit of would be a bit too much, because I don't know how many pickups I will have in here, and if I really want to drop them, or if I want to carry them around. And so I think deleting the or destroying the game objects when I pick them up and instantiating new ones isn't that big of a deal. But maybe I will change that at some point, but I thought of this pickup holder as quite of a good idea, just to keep a bit more structure in here. So let's go to our game manager and add that public variable in here. Public transform. Pickup holder. And it's a transform because the parent is child of the transform class, so it's easier to just take the transform, not the game object, and then get the transform and then set the parent and set the parent for the other objects. So in here, once we do instantiate them, if we drop our item, here we are instantiating it and we are creating a temporary game object here anyway, so we can go in here and set the parent for that. So go dot transform parent equal to pickup holder. So we just need to connect it in the editor and everything there will be fine. We don't want to set the position because the pickups need to have their own position in world. But the parent is good just for sake of sanity and organization. Not that I'm OCD or something, but it's always good to have some kind of structure in your code and in your hierarchies and stuff like that. It's bad enough that the assets sometimes need to be in the root directory if you download some packages, and then they need to be in the root directory, and I cannot sort them in my own structures though, that so that I can properly use it. But for this case here, it's fine. I know what I added in and what are mine, what are not, which are not mine, and it's not that much, so it's still manageable. So we need to go in here. And we need to get that exposed into the normal in the inspector here, so we can connect it. But since we have the con inspector set to show the default inspector, we can connect it down here and set that later. So that should be okay. And let's save this. And another thing we can do is go in our prefabs and create prefab for our managers. No, we don't want to do that. That's we should create a prefab for our UI manager. At least. If you do it for the managers, then we will take the pickups with it, and that's too much. We don't need them. But we can take the UI manager, which is fine, which only has a canvas and all the other stuff under the canvas in it. And the game manager is set as a singleton class, so it won't be destroyed when we change the level. So, if we start from this level and always from this level, then it should be fine. Otherwise, we need to start from a level where we don't scene. We don't need any of the functions that are in these managers, and then load in the world, or we should copy the manager object to our other scenes. So I have access to all this here, and all the mechanics work because they need the game manager for their communication. Let's try if this worked. And if you watch the left side in the hierarchy, then it worked there. And if we go into our inventory, and if we drop items, then they're added in the right to the right object for the into the pickup holder. And I accidentally clicked one time too often, so now I have an unassigned reference exception here, and I need to exit out and fix that because it shows up. Wanted to remove an item that's no longer there, that's not assigned. And we need to go in our code and update our UI once we drop an item. So in here, an item. Okay, we don't have anything that tells our GUI manager that the she needs to update once we drop the item. So let's go in our GUI manager and have a look what happens if we press that button. If we update it then, but didn't look like it. Yeah, here we say update, but we don't set the info panel to not active, which results in data problems if we have more than one item. So let's set this to non-active. So we need to click a new item, select the new item, and then we are fine. I think so is we could you move this code down here out of the if else section and it will call, this is called always, so it always resets the selected item, and it always deactivates the item info panel, which is good if we want to remove items, and it's also good if you want to remove part of the stack, because it could be that the right item isn't there anymore, one that we had selected, and if we want to remove that, if we want to drop that, then we could get memory errors and some kind of allocation error that we had earlier. So it's best to just set the selected item to null and then set the info panel to not active. And that way we don't have the button anymore. We cannot click it, which is quite useful. So if we move this out of the way, I should do that in the editor. And I should change the speed of the sun. It's kind of annoying. If I click this and drop one of them, it's deactivated. And I have to click it again to select the new item. So this way I'm sure that all the items, all the data in here is actually filled with correct data and not data from the previously removed object, and we don't get an error here. And we don't get any memory loss in the end product, which we would get. These four I created by dropping them, but the problem is since I set this one to infinite, if I go into the bound error, the item itself is infinite, so the idea is that I have some kind of item in the game that would make sense if it was infinite. Like, if I'm picking up water out of the river, then I wouldn't destroy the river. I would just fill up something with water and would get water. And I could do that as often as I want. And if I pick up a rock on a rock slide, then would be the same. I would always pick up rocks, and because I wouldn't remove the mountain, because it's kind of makes sense that there are rocks there, so why not be able to pick them up? For something like this, I created this is item infinite variable, and it doesn't destroy the base item, the base pickup in the world. But problem is that if you have the item set up is infinite and you pick them up and drop them, then you create multiple infinite items in the world. So I need to be careful with playing around with that. I mean, it's not really important, but if I drop too many of them, then it could be kind of annoying at some point. Okay. This and we didn't do need to do this in here. So let's remove the comments there. This was the last thing we did before the break and fixed the error I had in there. Yeah, I don't need this here because I'm handling that in the game manager. And let's go in the game manager inspector and get us the object field for our for the transform. And let's put this down here. And let's go pickup holder. And we need an object field. We need for this. Get the object, so it's not the wrong right one, so string label, object, and we need the object type. And then we have other options. But we need to change to this, and yeah, we need to change this to this. So we need the label, which is this string label, object type. Then we need to add a bool that says if we allow scene object or not, and then other parameters after that. So we have this. We have label, we have the object, so we need to add the type. And this is type of transform. And then we need the do we want to allow scene objects? I think in this case it's true. So this should be okay. And it isn't. Okay, and then we need to change this to a transform. So we need to typecast that to a transform, and that's C-sharp or JavaScript or .NET way to typecast. Could also do it front here. Be exactly the same if I type it right. Could also type it this way. But kind of like this way, so we know. Okay, we take this one as this type. That's this what are they called? Command? No, operator. I think it's an operator in this case. So now we have access to that, and we can also deactivate this one because I think we don't need that anymore, and we'll tidy up our inspector. Did I save it? Yes. And if we click on it, it's only the data I need in here. I could add the quick bar. Could add a list for the quick bar, so we have the quick bar listed here as well. And we need to remove the currency amount because we don't use that anymore. And currency here. Let's comment that out. I don't need it in this context here. So to go in here and comment it out. Let's leave this here for the moment, because I need it only for debugging, and I don't need the quick bar to be part of this UI. I only need it for testing out everything, and I'm not sure if I need it for more. Yeah, let's leave it that way. And now we quick bar and inventory is shown again. And if we move this over here, you can see it. Because this area here is blocked by the chat box. But you are quiet there, so it's empty. But it's fine. I'm also a lurker in some chats, and it's totally fine. It's nice that you're here and watch. Okay, next thing I wanted to do is try to figure out our door inspector. We don't need the door. Yeah, like I said, it's totally fine. Thanks for the follow. So we were looking at the dragging and then dropping. So to go to our drop target, and here we were trying to figure out how to split our stacks, which so far didn't work. Not now. Then we want to do that. Just for security, so that we don't send an event and it's going nowhere and doesn't have a receiver. That's and same thing here. It's quick bar, yes. Save this and have a look. Do we have any references to it? Yes, we have. That's good. So in here, we remove it from the inventory. Split it into the inventory. The code is all mine, I would say. I'm not sure if I'm using anything from the asset store. I think not. So code wise it's all mine. Art wise it's all asset store. So you see where my focus lies. All these houses here in the village are asset store assets, and it's all modular assets from yeah. Most of the time I'm saying, okay, I'm a game developer, because I could be doing simple models myself, and I could even try to texture them, but that's not really good looking. But I know how to work in 3D, so it's no problem in that regard, but as soon as I'm trying to tackle textures, it's horrible. Lighting in 2D project. I think I saw a really cool plugin for that earlier. I think last week or this week. Yeah, something like this. That's I think it was this one. There's a free version and there's a pro version of this one. And it's not even that expensive. Or you can have lights and shadows. Yeah. That's the popular effect that for 2D games at the moment. Yeah, there's a free version. Just try this one. Maybe it helps you. And if you maybe need more, then without a doubt, you can always add plugins into there, and you don't need to use the features on your in your scene. You can just test it in a separate scene, and if you see, okay, that's exactly what I want, and then you can build it into your main scene or your scenes if you have multiple, and then test it out that way and be sure that it doesn't break anything. Easiest is make a copy of your scene that you want to put it in and throw it in your copy and play around with it there, and if it breaks anything, throw it in an empty scene and work only with the plugin itself and figure out how it works there, and that's what I would do. And for my scene, I will add one of the terrain shader plugins that I really like later, and hope that everything works out and I can change the shader of my terrain and add really nice features like height blending and parallax blending and adding hollow terrain pieces, meshes blended with the terrain in for caves and stuff like that. Yeah, the thing is, if you're really not sure if it'll work with your system, throw it in an empty scene first. Sometimes the plugins are set up in a completely different way as you would think about it, but if you just play around with them a bit, you can figure them out. So, you have the asset store. You can use all of it, and if it's a free plugin like the light thingy here, if there's a free version, it's no harm if it doesn't work out for you. But if you had to pay $100 for an effect like this, then it would be kind of a pain to figure out, oh no, it doesn't work for me. So it's really nice that they provide you with a free version you can test, and it seems to be limited in some way, and then you can go for the pro version. So if you want to test just some feature out, look if there's free plugin for it, if you don't think you want to do it on your own. For my code and my the ATK stuff I have in here, all the source code there, I started writing this complete system about 3 or 4 years ago for a point-and-click adventure game, and I took that and updated it in the last few weeks, and I'm still in the process of updating it and having it here, but the base of it, yes, I can do that. No problem at all. Yeah, like I said, the base of it I created years ago, and okay, one thing first, I created this terrain with the help of Gaia, and Gaia helps you with creating good-looking terrain by combining different height maps together, and then it takes care of the texturing for you and placing of trees and grass and stuff like that, and even places game objects around the world like farms and rocks and stuff like that. So I can show you those. But these houses here I placed myself, and that stuff over there, all this area here, and that I placed myself. And apart from that big house over there, all the other houses in this area here were procedurally placed by Gaia. But it's not really cheap, but it's a really good plugin and helps a lot. And if I go in here, I can show you the mechanics I have in here. I'm not sure what I will use this for, but I can pick up this block, and by pick up I don't mean put it in my inventory, but move it around in the world. And I also can have a pressure plate here that I will use it, I'll use for something later, for maybe controlling a door lock or lights or stuff like that for puzzles, if I want to have them in the game, which I'm not sure yet. And here, pickups. Gives you a message, okay, you picked up something. This item is infinite, so it's not. Yeah. And infinite items are not removed. Normal items are removed out of the world and just put in my inventory. And I can do that. And then I have my inventory here. And you can see I picked up, not sure if you can really see it, but that's a three there in the corner. And all the other items, I have only one of the them, and this one is a stack of three breadcrumbs. And I can move them into my quick bar. And if I click the one button for the first quick bar slot, I'm using the item that's in there. And for some reason, at the moment, it removes the whole item. And I just wasted two items that I could have used otherwise, because the stacking doesn't work right at the moment. And in this case, I just ate the bread pieces that I had there, breadcrumbs. I also have a dialogue system in here, which could be as elaborate as you want it to be. In this case, it's just one line here and two lines I can say. And then he says goodbye, and we can do something else. Can go in here in our manager. No, not yet. Nothing like that. No safe or database persistent. In here I have global conditions. These are saved into a a scriptable object. So it's just a file that comes with the that I created and that's sitting in my project, and I can change this this value here so that the program doesn't know that we talked to him already. And if we leave that open and talk to him or me, in this case that's me, myself, and I, my representation in the world, and in this case he just says hello and I have the option to say goodbye, and now the value has changed over here. And if we talk to him again, he says hello again and goodbye again. And here I have another option, root option, if I just click this test and click here and talk to him again, it's not shown anymore. So that way I can control my dialog options and the complete dialog with conditions that I can set up outside and connect to my dialog system. The problem is my dialog editor is kind of iffy at the moment. So if I'm opening up one of my dialogs, it doesn't really show, kind of select anything here, which is kind of a pain. There is a dialog here, and I have created this line editor, dialog editor, but for some reason the display is broken. I need to go back into it at some point and fix that. Yep. And the other aspect is that I'm thinking about maybe selling that ADK, the Adventure Toolkit, what I call it, on the asset store at some point. But for that, it needs to be presentable and working and have multiple features that people would like to have in their games. I wanted to do that years ago, but the problem is that then the where is it? Where's that damn package? There's one dialog system that just came out when I wanted to release mine. Oh, here it is. This, the Adventure Creator. That came out just when I wanted to release mine, or wanted to upload it and get approval, but so, okay, this one came out and it does everything I wanted to do and gives even more options to it and has lots of imports that I don't have and it works well with others and has 2D features and all that stuff, and I don't have that in mine, so I just didn't release mine because I thought, no, it's not worth it. No problem at all. I like to talk to people, it's really no problem. And if you have questions or comments, just ask or say something. Like I said, it's completely fine. But I will try to get back to it so we can maybe fix that system. So the problem was that when we used the item, it removed all of them. So Yes. And not only the pickups, but also my items have an is infinite option. Bool in this case, and it's even makes even more sense for my items because I don't want to destroy my axe or sword when I'm using it to hit someone or destroy something in front of me, so I don't want it to break with one hit. I want to change that, so I want to have the infinite in here, and I have no weapon and no fighting in the system in here, but it can be extended and it could add it in, but I have no plans to do that. So here we need to check if the item is the item mount is higher than one. Quick bar index. Mount is higher one, then we need to handle it there, else we have our code already in here. So function for that? So we basically need to go in here and change that because we can't use the. Wait, do we have it in the inventory still? Are quick bar items in the inventory? Yes, they are. So I can use this because I changed that already. This remove from inventory. I can use this one in here. So, as we are doing the check in there, I think we can just use this here. Let's comment this out and test it. Oh, we need. Do we want to split it? Okay, what does that do in our. Yes, we want to split it, okay. Yes. And this will check if it's if the amount is higher and do all the rest. I'm not sure if it doesn't call this function though, so we need to we need to check that. I think we need to add this in again, and we need to fire this event here. It's an event, and this should help us there. So let's get back in here. And pick up our breadcrumbs. And move them in here. Let's try this. Okay. That worked, but it didn't change the UI. So we need to fix the. We need to update the UI. So we need to tell the UI, hey, you need to update yourself. And do we do that somewhere up here already? So do we already have a function for that? Nope, doesn't look like it. Okay, I mean, we could call the inventory list update, but I don't think that that will help us. What does it do? On update inventory list. Nope. Wait. Now I have to check. Are they moved to the QuickBar, or are they just, are they still part of the list? That's the important part. Theoretically, this shouldn't be any harmful if we call it once more, so let's try it. If it does something screwy, then we need to change that. Okay, on remove used item. Maybe we should call that and write a check in there so we here it is. Okay. Yes, we're removing it and destroying these. Okay. Yes, we need to call this one because when we only have one item left, we want to remove that. So we need to destroy that, or we need to call an update in here. So we don't, we only need to fire that event and then check the results in the UI manager. So we need to do this. And then we need to go in here and extend this a bit. Okay. Do we have... Yeah. I need that, so it can, this can be in here. And we don't need that lock anymore. So if we UI item dot item data dot amount is higher 1, then we want to do something here, else you want to do what's down there. And here we only need to call the update. Where is it? Update this one. And we need the UI item dot item data and the UI item itself. Okay. And now it should work here. Null reference. What's that? Okay, that was from earlier. Something. Okay. Let's try this. Let's move it over here. And we use that. And nothing happens. Okay. And now we get null reference exceptions because the item we are using is not there anymore. Okay, so that's not working. Oh, yes. Yeah, that's a problem because we are moving them out of our inventory into our... so we need to copy this one and do the same for the quick bar. Basically, we take something. Let me change this. Bool. Quick bar. And then we go in here. If not, is quick bar. Then we do that. Else. Is that wrong? I should be streaming for at least 2 or 3 hours, so maybe? Here and do it this way. What am I doing there? Okay, that's much better. Okay, can't do find here. That's bool. Use link in here. Link would help, but I mean, I could change it to a list and then work with that, but I'm not sure if that break anything. Let's try this and see what happens.
Oh, yeah. False. True. Use quick item. Yes. And use quick bar is true. Yes. Here we need to also check if it's quick bar or not. It's not elegant that I'm checking for that here and there, but otherwise I would need to maybe duplicate that code, and I don't want to put it in another in a method, so it's not the best thing to do here. Not elegant, but it works, and that's something you have to keep in mind. If it works, why do something else for it? Maybe comment it then and tell why, but if your code works, awesome. If it looks horrible, yeah, tell people why if they want to look at your code. Items in there. Yeah, our inventory is empty. And they're in the quick bar. That's why I got the arrows earlier. Okay. And I got a problem in my code here. Okay. And it removed the item completely. Which is bad, so we already ate stale and moldy breadcrumbs, so let's do something else. Oh no, we can't do that because we are not referring to the exception. Speaking hard. Especially foreign language. And sorry for everyone that I offended with that accent. So, where was the problem? In here. Cannot find the item, so UI item is null. Damn it. That's not good. So we need to check if it's still in our UI items. And for that we need to have the list visible here. And let's check. Okay, the list holds two items, and these are the two items we have there. We can give it a bit more space around there, so it's a little bit bigger. And if we move it down there, it shouldn't change anything. Because there's still inventory items here, so that's should be fine. So if I close this and use that, it is removed here, and we have a problem there. So. The same problem we had before. Object reference not set to instead of an object. Yeah, and this is null. Because for some reason it couldn't find it. So we need to check the if we set this right. Okay, I hope I caught that in time so you don't need to hear me sneezing and blowing my nose. So let's have a look, see our references to that. And in here, if we drop it into the quick bar, we set the previous quick bar slot to this. So it should be fine. The item should have that this should be set right. And it's doing the same over here, because when we move it. Let's have a look. Go in here. Oh, do we by chance change? No, we don't. I'm not changing that. Remove from inventory, and then maybe we should change this. Yeah, okay, that's set up right there. So in here, for some reason it doesn't find the right item. So it cannot check the amount, but it removes it anyway, so let's just put a check around here. If your item is null, I need to remove these keys. They are annoying. I never used them. So it shouldn't be going in here when this is not found. Otherwise, all hell breaks loose like we just had there. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. Remove the item, which is kind of annoying. Because if we go in our I would have moved it here as well. That removed the complete slot there. That's not good. That's not good. Yeah, it shouldn't remove the slot, just should overwrite them as null. I mean, it really doesn't make a difference, to be honest, because we only set them to the right index anyway. But it didn't work, that's the important part. So this one didn't. The amount wasn't right. So let's set a breakpoint here, attach this to Unity and check. Okay, and now we are in here, and amount is 2, so it should update this one. What does update do? It changes the text. And it doesn't remove anything. So if we continue, what does it do? Okay. It removes it anyway. So it's not in here, but somewhere elsewhere it's having problems. So let's put a breakpoint there, just to be sure that it's really going through there and not have a problem here. And do this again. Okay, it is going in here because our item data really has the amount of 2. So that's good. And step into this, does that. It's okay, step over. It's the next thing it does. Okay, finished here. So now what does it do? Goes in here. The rest here. It's fine. Okay. And now it shows me this. And if I close that. Yay. So much for that. Let's end this. Is it still? Yeah, it's gone. Ah, I like that. Yay. But it's not using additional RAM, so that's nice of it. It's just frozen. Yay. Okay, that was saved, that's good. So, didn't destroy too much. Doing that, and if I close this, press this, then okay, it's just removing that, and this is working. Okay, just killed itself because it was still in debug mode here and kind of couldn't handle it. I don't know. Sometimes Unity is a bit broken. But that's okay. Or maybe it's not Unity, but my code that's doing something that it shouldn't do. But it's still not, this is still not working right, so. Console, clear all that. Okay, so this should have been 3, this 2, so it's doing something really strange down there. Why do we get this one more than once? get input. It's called in fixed update. References. And it's only used here. This shows the success. Let's go in here and check this. Removed from the inventory somehow. Oh, need to restart this. Get the UI manager, and here we have the moment the inventory size is 0, which is fine because we never opened the inventory yet. So if we open it, it should change to 1. Changed to 1 and it created 1 item. And we move this here, close our inventory. And let's go to the to this, and in here quick bar item is our item that we have. Doesn't have a name or a or anything, because it's just a an empty reference. No, it's not an empty reference, but it's just doesn't have a name assigned to it in that regard. It's a scriptable object, and this doesn't have a name, and this does have a name, so that's the difference there. So let's go back here, and it's not in the inventory anymore because it's part of the quick bar. Also makes sense. So if we click the button, we go in here. Use quick bar item. Did we get that use? And it's crashed again. Damn it. So the idea that I could use the use list here only gives me problems. Because I can't. Item remove from inventory quick bar index. And let's check this one. Used item here, it's just this here, and that's what we went through. And I think it's here that it's crashing because it cannot find the item and just does something screwy. I don't know. Okay. It gives us null. And that's the problem. Not only gives us null, but it triggered that twice. Yeah, use breadcrumbs there. Success triggered. And then here. But here the amount is already 2. After that, the amount is still 2. And then it's using it again. And also, and then in here gives us the item, gives us this. That's the third time. Why is it called 3 times? Doesn't make sense. Let's test something really quick. What happens if I only pick up 2 of these? Is it called twice then, or is it also called 3 times? It's called twice. So look at this, what does that do? Maybe we are using it completely wrong. That's always a possibility. Here, but to search here, Hub list find. Okay. I think we're using the wrong. Should be using exists, which does the same check, but let's try this. Exists. Yeah, no, we wanted to get the, that's the problem. I don't want to use it if it exists, but if it's okay. Yeah, the problem is it doesn't just find one. It finds many of them. Why does it find more than one? Doesn't make sense. Okay, let's have a look at that. Don't have access to that. Yeah. Let's do something else for that. Could be a bit more code, but it's okay. So, let's go through these. Okay, sorry about that. Need to sneeze again. I hate being ill. So, since find does this in itself, I just try to do it on my own. So let's do something else here. We have our item. This one, and this is now, and let's call this one item, so we don't confuse them. Not equals index, Then we set the UI item to item. And what we also do is break out of the loop. So we definitely only do that once. And then down here we go through the rest. So it's basically the same what I did before, but this way I really break out of the loop and have more control over it. So for me that's better. Might not be clear code, but that's okay. And I'm not sure if I'm using find somewhere else in here. So let's try this, if this changes anything. If I understood that right, basically shouldn't change anything, but I'm not sure. Or maybe it helps in our case, just is okay. Press this. No, didn't change anything. And we still get use it in slot 0. And it's 2. And that's not right. So it is decreased before. It's shown. So it's still the same error we have in here somewhere. Could be simple logic error. Remove from inventory. Okay, go to definition. Does that do? I want to have some kind of feedback when I'm picking up items, and at the moment it's that dialogue, and later it will be sound effect or particle effect or something that tells you, okay, you picked up something. Or maybe something on the UI in a corner where your inventory could be blinking or stuff like that, so you know, okay, you picked up something. You need some kind of feedback, and at the moment it's just that dialogue. And I know for more items it's annoying, and I will remove it at some point. Yeah, that's another idea. Or have it a bit less in your face and move it here. Remove the train. And the UI manager, the canvas. This is, that's the dialogue there. And I could move it to the side here, so it just pops up here and you can close it. Because it's blocking the view. And but what it also does is it freezes the mouse look. So you have the cursor back and you need to click on it. And that brings you out of the game, and that's at the moment okay, because I want to have the feedback and really know, okay, now I picked up something. But for the game it's a bit too much. So I want to have some kind of sound effect, or maybe I'm adding some kind of inventory indicator here and let that blink, like I said. But at the moment it's for debugging mostly. And to be sure that I'm getting the right item, which is debugging. But I'm using this description panel for all the descriptions in game or the actions in game where you get text feedback. So it's just a simple message system. The same as before. I'm still on my damn stacking thing on the quick bar. I haven't moved on from that, sadly. Still not doing what I want. If I move this here and click, then it removes all of them, all of the items here, gives me the dialogue once, and then all the other items are gone. And if I look through here, it's calling the use breadcrumbs here, then gives me wrong amount because it already decreased it by one, and then it used it again and then destroys it. The use item, use quick bar item, if quick bar index focus not null, and then we show success. And then we remove it from inventory. And if we go to that, we go in here. We're trying to find the item. And if it's, if we have more than one item, we want to decrease the amount. Otherwise, we want to remove it. And we also need to tell our UI, and that's in here, and that's this one here, and here that's the problem I am having. It's in here somewhere, but I'm not sure what the problem exactly is, so. In the UI. Yeah. Oh, what do you mean? Oh, do you mean this one? Because here I'm checking if the item is in my inventory or is in my quick bar. So here, okay. I'm just using that to check if it's there. Yeah, I'm giving a reference to the item. And then I'm checking if it's there. Yeah, okay, I could. But the thing is, it looks strange in here. And let me check that. The thing is, it isn't removed. So it's not removed from the quick bar. It's removed. It's only the UI that kind of makes problems. So if we go in here and we have a look at our quick bar, least I don't think it's removed there. Could be that the references are wrong. And I only have one inventory item in here, which is fine, it's this. And we need to move this here so that you can see the quick bar. So if I'm moving it over here, then now we have no inventory item. And we have one item in slot 0 in our quick bar. And if we use that. Oh! Yes, we have a problem there. Okay, then it's removed here, which shouldn't be the case. Thank you! My problem wasn't in my UI, it was in the other code. Thank you very much! Yeah, sometimes just if someone else has a look at it, it might help. So, maybe I don't need this. So let's check, let's change this to item data and have a look then. Maybe we have a problem in there. Yeah, I know. Sometimes works if I take a break, walk away, and come back an hour later or so. But in this case, maybe I just did something wrong. So basically, we might not even need the item here. Let's test it this way and look if it's removed or not. And then we check the rest over here. Yep. That's the problem. I mean, I have a friend that who does that. He's keeping his stream running for an hour or so when he's just taking a break, and he has a video running or some in-game cutscene for the menu or stuff like that. Okay, so this is interesting. It helped. This time we still have the item in our quick bar, so the first error is done, but the second one isn't, because it was removed from our quick bar in the UI, so we need to check that as well. So, thank you. That's good, yeah. Should use that as well. I have a few Lego figures lying around on my desk. At the moment they are kind of buried under some paper, but yeah, we don't need the item here anymore, so we can just go through all of that and comment it out. But we also need to go in here and check this one, because for some reason it removes the item here as well, but we don't want it to be removed. So, and here we only get the index. That's the problem. I'm checking for the index, and it's when it finds the index, then it should break out of this, but it still removes all of it and does strange stuff for me. But let me check what was in the console here. Okay, that's all the other triggers. And yeah, I will do that. But the thing is that still this is still wrong here. It's
changing the value at the wrong time. But let's test if the change we made, the commenting out, if that worked. Didn't. It didn't help because now it's removed from the quick bar.